accommodating, you know, like I said. So in 1963, where Papua faced a banning order, the banning order came because he was that great. Papua defeated Gary Player, the then South African champion, on innumerable occasions. He beat him so bad that they had to ban him. Can you imagine, guys? Like, that's the unfortunate thing, is that we are so great as a civilization, of dark-skinned people. We are so great that we, our presence makes the white man feel inferior. Our is so great as the tragedy of apartheid. Why is he titled as the tragedy of apartheid? Because he was such a great player. He was a hero of a nation. He was a golfing legend, a master, that he was facing so many adversities. He had an adversity from the government. He had an adversity from the playing conditions. He had an adversity from his place where he stayed. So yeah, let's go into the next slide, turning pro. So here, as I'm getting into my point, Papua emerged at a time where there was a deep depression in South Africa, where either in South Africa, all the popular leadership was either jailed or banned. The Natal Indian Congress was either defect or killed. Robert Sobukwe was behind bars. And people were looking for a leader whose dreams to at least embarrass the whites. So Papua was that man. Papua was the man who's now embarrassing the whites because of his greatness, of how he was such a great player. People were looking for a leader, if not who could articulate the dreams to at least embarrass the whites at the golf course. He lived on the golf course, not literally, figuratively. He lived on the golf course. That was his game. Politics were out. Even though it hit him hard and he felt it, he knew he was a golfer and he stuck to it, and that is where he belonged. So this point I'm mentioning here of how he knew he was a golfer, of when he was a pro and before he was a pro. There's a very good temperament, and he was exceptional. He was very calm and collected, but not actually shown the most